Hey, Nagito, any ideas?
Probably.
Hey, how long are you gonna stay quiet?
Oh, am I allowed to speak?
We asked you a question, speak.
I'm so happy I'm getting goosebumps. Everyone actually needs help from scum like me. So what do you think?
I was thinking about it while I had my mouth shut. But now I'm finally able to come to a conclusion.
Okay.
Ibuki definitely didn't commit suicide.
No, she didn't.
Huh? What are you talking about?
I thought there might be a possibility that she faked her death and tampered with the crime scene.
That's too far-fetched.
But now I remember. There was blood on Ibuki's slippers.
Yes.
So if she faked her death and walked around the music venue tampering with the crime scene, there'd be bloody footprints left in various places throughout the venue.
There's not.
So that's why I think there's no way she faked her death. There's no way Ibuki committed suicide.
There's also another major reason.
We already finished talking about that a while ago.
Really? That's annoying. I guess I should just awkwardly laugh about it then.
You know what's wrong.
Are you freaking kidding me? There's no limit to how useless you can be!
No. Wait a minute. If Ibuki had blood on her feet, there'd be footprints all over the place if she kept walking around.
That's strange. That's very strange.
This is strange? What's strange?
Let's see. It's not something we finished talking about. These footprints. There's still an important clue left that we completely overlooked. Just as Nagio said, if she had blood on her feet, she would have left footprints. And why weren't there any footprints on the stepladder?
I can prove it with this!
If Ibuki used the stepladder to hang herself, it's strange that there weren't any footprints on it.
Huh? There weren't?
Nope.
Yeah, that stepladder was completely clean. No footprints or bloodstains at all.
Well, other than on the left side.
Did you notice such a small detail? How amazing! This is truly the talent of a chosen ultimate!
Nagito, you knew this. What are you talking about? You were obviously leading us to this. That's why you brought up the suicide topic after all this time. Nagito Kumaeda. You're definitely someone I shouldn't underestimate.
But didn't you say you saw that video of Ibuki climbing the stepladder? Then I think there's no doubt that she really did climb it. Unless there was something funny about that video.
Yeah.
I see. So there was some kind of trick arranged in that video,
But that's something only Hajime would know, since he's the only one who saw that video.
So, just so I thought, it comes down to that. The mystery surrounding this incident is contained in that video. And whether or not we can reach that hidden truth is all up to me.
Hajime, I leave it in your hands.
God damn it, why is it me?
As long as I leave this to you, I won't tell you to do your best, but oh well. You should get started already.
Assuming another logic dive.
Yeah, I'll definitely try.
If there was some hidden clue in that video, I should have seen something strange as I watched it. I'm the only one who can clear that up. I'm the only one who actually saw that video. So I'm the only one who can do it. The hanging video that I saw. Based on everything I know from the debates thus far, I should be able to figure out what's strange. Well,
here!
The stepladder itself. There's no blood on it.
That's right, I remember now. There was definitely something strange about that video.
Can you explain it to us?
What's strange is that stepladder I mentioned earlier. It's true that the steps of that stepladder weren't dirty, but on one side, there was a bloodstain, right on the left side of the stepladder. However, that contradicts the video I saw at the hospital. There weren't any bloodstains on the stepladder in the video. It was completely clean.
Yep.
That is truly strange. If the video showed the moment of Ibuki's death, then Miyoko should have already been dead by that point.
Choice by blood, but there isn't.
Even so, the fact is the stepladder had blood on it at the actual crime scene. The stepladder in the video was completely bloodless.
There's no way the video was recorded in advance. If that's the case,
The only thing I can think of is...
It's possible those two stepladders were completely different.
Yep.
Wait, are you saying there were two stepladders?
But where would you find another stepladder? There was only one stepladder in the music venue.
Why not from the market?
And one of the stepladders was somewhere other than the music venue.
What do you mean?
You're suggesting that the stepladder in the video isn't the only thing that's different. Am I right? That's amazing, Chiaki. All that gaming has given you incredible deduction skills. Is it okay to say that?
Sure.
What are you two talking about?
Well, stepladder is the only thing that's different, huh? Chiaki said the stepladder was at a different place, but if that's the case, the thing that's different between that video and the actual scene of the crime is that thing. The place where the killer did something. Oh, jeez. Oh, God, come on now. This is going to take forever. Learn caution to the wind. It's not I. Is it? Gee, no. L. If I can get the first letter, I can get through this shit. Not an M either. God damn it! Stop with all the letters! I'm gonna go insane! Nin I. Ugh. I think? Maybe? At this rate, I don't know what I need. I need a vowel. I don't think it's an O, right? Oh, no, okay. Something, oh, location. Oops, shit. Well, I fucked that one up. Fuck! Man, I am taking so much damage in this one. Okay. Need I win? Ah, shit. What? What the fuck? What the fuck happened there? Oh, I need it. There we go. Filming location. God damn it. Jesus Christ, me. Use my brain once in a while. Might be able to accomplish shit.
That's right. Besides the stepladder, the filming location must have been different too.
Exactly.
What do you mean?
I mean the video I saw was not filmed at the music venue. It was filmed somewhere else.
There's only one place that fits that bill.
But the hospital monitor is supposed to display footage captured by the music venue camera, you know?
Then there's a possibility that the killer also tampered with the surveillance camera unit.
Why not, right? In order to show us that they filmed the video at the music venue instead of somewhere else, what did the killer do to the surveillance camera unit? Oh jeez. Doing a logic dive? Okay, cool. God damn, this chapter is just full of Just all of it. Okay. Oh jeez. It's gonna get to the point where like I only have like one path I can take. Now these little branches. Okay, question one. What part of the surveillance camera unit did the killer tamper with? Probably both, right? Or yeah, okay, cool. No. Okay, so it's the camera. I mean, it doesn't matter which, like either one would be fine. Really wouldn't matter. Like, I know they say camera, but it wouldn't matter what you mess with, you know? Shit! I almost made it. I almost pulled an awesome jump, you know? Woohoo! That was cool. Oh shit. Should have voted a little too much there. Make sure I don't fall off again. There we go. Question two. Did the killer tamper with the camera at the music venue or the hospital? No. Oh, shit. No. Okay. I may have fallen, but I'm okay. I'd have been the one at the hospital, right? No, shit. Damn it. Okay. So, okay, no, that would make sense. My brain. I'm stupid. I'm very, very stupid. Don't blame me. Okay. Yeah, because the one at the music venue would be the one that goes to the hospital's camera, and, I feel stupid. I was gonna say, the music just dropped. What the fuck? I get my next question. Okay. What did the killer do with the camera from the music venue surveillance camera unit? Well, took it with them, right? They wouldn't have the technology to increase the signal. And victory! Okay. God, that was bad.
It's all coming together.
I always fuck up the logic dives.
That's it. The killer just brought the camera from the music venue. With it, they made me think it was a live feed from the venue, when it was actually from somewhere else.
Then, only the monitor was left in the music venue?
Yes, at least when I first discovered Ibuki's body. But when Hyoko's body appeared, the killer probably put the camera back too.
That means you should have realized that from the start, and made this easier on all of us.
Well, guess what? I didn't know.
He did discover the body. I doubt his attention was focused on the camera.
Well, that's true, but in order to hide that the camera was missing, the killer did one more thing to the remaining monitor.
What the killer did to the remaining monitor was destroy it? Because there was that destroyed
the
stuff.
The killer smashed the monitor to pieces, destroying it.
Yeah. Back in the music.
As long as it was in pieces, you wouldn't be able to tell if the camera was actually there or not.
Because it's a small camera.
My attention was so focused on the body that even I couldn't have noticed something like that.
And the moment Hajime left the music venue, the killer put back the camera they took.
Yeah.
And they destroyed it and left that
shit
as well.
Yep, it's obvious that there's more there.
It's easy to say it was filmed somewhere else, but the surveillance camera's connection wasn't that strong.
Despite Kazuichi's desperate repair efforts, it seems it could not transmit from the hospital to the motel.
The fact that it was able to connect between the hospital and the music thing was amazing enough.
Which means even if it was filmed in another place, as long as it was transmitting to the hospital, the range would be pretty limited. So, if that's the case, where did the video film to make it look like it was filmed in the music venue? The only possibility is that place inside that building. Really? You're going to make me do another fucking hangman's gambit? You game, you are lucky I am not stupid and know exactly what you're talking about this time. I hate Hangman's Gambits in this game. They are the most time-consuming and frustratingly health-driving game. Keep you two alive. I need an N. Wait till this little part in there more. Confer. Any. Give me an E. That's an F. This R and this O are useless right now. Shit! 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 I fucked that up. Fucked that up real bad. Fuck. Game. Game. Review. Get review. Review. Get review. All this. Be gone, foul beasts. Fuck! Game. Game. Oh, never mind. I'll just get rid of that. There we go. My god. Game. Oh, Eggman's Gambits are just murder fields.
It was filmed at the hospital's conference room.
Huh? Conference room?
But yep. The hospital and the music venue look completely different.
That's exactly why the killer did something to make those two places resemble each other.
To make the conference room look like the music venue, the killer went ahead and did some work. I've got to make that clear what that work was. Okay, we're going to a non-stop debate for some reason.
There's no way the conference room and the music venue look the same.
Which place resembled the other? Did the conference room look like the music venue? Or did the music venue look like the conference room?
That one.
That must be it.
Quickly answered.
What the killer did was make the music venue, the crime scene, look like the conference room. They did that by using the black curtain hanging at the back of the stage.
It wasn't black
curtain. I remember, there used to be a really flashy curtain, but after the incident,
it was extremely shortened and black.
It somehow became a plain black curtain that didn't seem to be the right size.
Eventually, the flashy one's still there.
That's right! It's so half-assed, just like Monami.
Oh, yeah? Well, your face looks.
That curtain was hung so the music venue would look like a conference room? In actuality, even though the curtain in the conference room doesn't stand out, it is a black light-blocking curtain that's long enough to reach the floor.
Yep.
I see. The conference room. Indeed, the floor of that room is...
made of wood.
The same color as the music venue stage.
Which is also
so the killer chose the conference room because they realized the floor matched.
Even you're just not realizing
matching
it,
floors,
really.
Matching curtains. I guess it makes sense you'd mistake the two.
But that's not all. There should be something else the killer did to tamper with the evidence. Probably.
Something else the killer did to make the music venue look like the conference room. It's gotta be that. Wait, which part? Oh yeah, the candle.
I can prove it with this.
Like, which part? Oh, a candle.
You're referring to the candle in the music video, right?
Yeah, the candle would do it.
In the video I saw, a candle was used for light. If you think about it, it's pretty strange. The music venue has good light, so there's no reason to even use candlelight.
Yep.
Wouldn't they have done it to make it feel creepier?
Nah, that wouldn't
that
be worth it.
That might have been another reason, but the main reason was probably to tamper with evidence. The lighting in the conference room and the music venue are so different. They couldn't be used during filming.
Yep.
That's why the killer used a candle with film lighting instead.
Which means, are you saying the candle in the music venue wasn't actually used?
Might have been
that
used
candle
at some
was
point.
Likely placed there just to make me think it was the same candle that was used in the video.
Yeah. Oh no, it probably is the same candle.
With candlelight, you can't see things in that much detail. Maybe they were going for that effect. With that cheap-ass camera, it won't capture much in a dark area.
As long as this all matches up, it should be no problem to say this is the site. The video I saw wasn't filmed at the music venue. It was actually filmed at the hospital conference room.
If I'd found proof that evidence in the conference room was altered, we would have reached an answer sooner.
But there was nothing in there.
But it appears the killer already covered that up. So I didn't find anything when I went there.
Sadly.
But there's no mistake. That's the only place within the connection range of the surveillance camera.
The motel would have been too far, and the interior design of the movie theater is too distinctive.
Yep.
But this must be a surprising turn of events for Hajime. You never suspected that the video you saw in the hospital was being filmed in the conference room.
The incident isn't happening at the scene of a crime. It's occurring in the conference room.
I feel like I've heard Bayside cops say that before, but isn't it the other way around?
If Ibuki's hanging video was filmed at the hospital's conference room, then was Ibuki killed at the conference room too?
No.
No, that's not possible.
She was killed in the...
Right after Hajime saw that video, he discovered Ibuki's body at the music venue.
The video was filmed at the conference room, but Ibuki's body was at the music venue, which means there was a fake somewhere. The fake must have been the Ibuki in the conference room.
The person wearing the hint bag in that video wasn't Ibuki. It was the killer pretending to be Ibuki. The killer put on a hospital gown, wore a hint bag on their head, and was only pretending to be the victim.
By that time, the real Ibuki must have already been killed.
The actual time of death must have been earlier. Probably around midnight or dawn to avoid witnesses.
Makes sense to me.
If they took Ibuki from the music venue to the hospital to kill her, there's no way it happened during the day.
So everyone was killed the night before. So that's what happened. Then, no matter how quickly I ran, it was impossible for me to rescue Ibuki. At that moment, I was already in the killer's trap. And the one who set the trap for me was...
But why did the killer go to the trouble of making a fake video just so Hajime could go to the crime scene?
The reason the killer made a fake video... There's only one possibility I can think of. And if I examine that possibility thoroughly...
Oh god.
Then naturally, the killer's identity will reveal itself.
Are you gonna make me do another logic dive?
Huh?
You fiend! Are you saying you already know who the killer is?
That's right. I should already know. I should have already known who the killer is. I hate saying it, but... Mikan, sorry.
You're the only one!
Yeah.
You're the killer, aren't you?
It feels so bad to say!
What are you talking about?
It feels so bad to say!
Seth, aren't you the killer who murdered Ibuki and Hyoko?
The killer? I'm the killer? What is this?
She's the only one.
Hey, don't you think that's kinda impossible?
No, it's completely
like
possible.
Her as the killer? She couldn't even kill a fly. In fact, the fly would probably kill her first.
She's right! A clumsy slowpoke like me killing someone? That's completely out of the question!
Gee, she's very much so pointing out her flaws.
We're the only ones. Thanks to that video, we're the only ones who have the advantage of an alibi.
An alibi? Was that the killer's goal?
Now that you mention it, you guys brought that up earlier. Only Hajime and Mikan have an alibi.
Yep.
It's just a coincidence.
But you're the only one who could have filmed that video in the hospital conference room.
Because we were the only ones in the hospital, other than Akane
and... Also a coincidence?
And Nagato. Shouldn't you get some rest already? You should be exhausted from nursing without any sleep, right? Then, if you insist, I will use the on-call room upstairs. You must be mentally exhausted, so it's better if you relax in the lobby instead.
At that time, you said you were going to the on-call room, but you actually went to the conference room.
Ah, it hurts. Why'd she do it?
That's when you put on a hospital gown that you prepared in advance, put the bag on your head, and began filming. By doing that, you made up a video that showed Ibuki trying to hang herself at the music video.
Yep.
And showed that to me. Furthermore, I saw that video at the hospital lobby. If someone wants to go to the conference room from outside, they have to pass through the lobby.
Exactly.
So it's impossible that someone who wasn't already in the hospital went to the conference room to film.
Not only that, the others in the hospital, Kane and I, were both delirious from the despair disease.
Yep.
So that must mean...
Please, wait a second!
What
are you saying? I'm the killer?
Yeah.
That's impossible! There's no way I could kill someone!
Unless you were sick.
It's not literally impossible. Can't you give a better defense than that?
Just shows she can't even do that.
Hey. You sure this chick is really the killer?
She has the opportunity.
Wrong! It's totally wrong! It's not what you think!
Just like Akane said, it is really hard to tie it all together. I mean, Mikan is the killer?
I agree. It is truly difficult to believe someone could be killed by such a slow-witted woman.
That slow-witted remark is not necessary.
Yeah, seriously, man.
It's fine. I've been like this for a long time. In a tournament for social punching bags, I'd easily win first place with my soft reputation.
Even so.
Even I can't deny that. How many times do I have to tell you? It's impossible for me to kill someone. I'm serious. Very serious.
What do you say, Hajime?
Do you still believe this woman is the killer?
Yes, I do.
Do you hate me that much, Hajime?
Hey, Hajime!
Shut up! Stop ganging up on me!
Everyone's
ganging up on me. But it's a good front. Tricks aside, logic aside, is she really capable of doing something like this? Could it be I'm the one making a mistake? No, in fact, it'd be so much easier if I was wrong. If I have this much doubt about someone I've spent so much time with...
Can you hold on a minute?
Huh?
Well, I know I'm being intrusive and all, and I mean, I have no place to say this. I missed all of the critical parts, and I doubt I have anything worth saying at an important time like this.
What are you saying?
But still... There's definitely no way I can overlook the killing this time.
It was a killing out of despair, not hope. Huh?
I thought it was suspicious all along, from the very beginning. Investigating with the suspect in mind creates a different result than investigating with no leads.
Hey, what are you trying to say?
Well, thanks to that, I was able to discover a truth that nobody else knows.
Oh?
Are you serious?
I've been so focused on everybody else this trial. But I guess now's a good time to say it, right?
Sure, say it, man.
You better not have kept quiet on purpose. This isn't a game, you know.
Actually, this is a game.
Shut up, Monokuma.
Please don't say such controversial statements.
Well, what do you know, Nagato?
Well, it's nothing big, really. Only a small, decisive clue that points to the killer.
Dang! That's a huge deal!
Yeah, seriously, man.
A decisive clue? Does something like that really exist?
Let's take a look. shall we?
What is it?
Regarding the rope Kuki was dangling from. This rope was supplied by the supermarket, right? There weren't any ropes inside the music venue.
No, there weren't.
Again with the supermarket? That place is a hotspot for criminal goods.
That's the point.
If they got it at the supermarket, that means it was brand new, right?
But it's not, huh?
What's wrong with that? I want you to take a close look at this rope. And keep in mind that it's brand new. Near the middle of the rope, it's frayed, as if it was rubbed strongly. But why is it like this? The loopy boopy used to hang herself is on one end of the rope.
Yeah.
And the part of the rope that hung from the baton lighting is on the other end.
Hey, you're taking too long. What's wrong with the rope being frayed?
It means that's well used.
It means, well, from what I can infer, I think the rope was used like this.
Well used in a way.
The killer wrapped the rope around Ibuki's neck, pulled both ends at full strength, and strangled her.
Jeez.
The center of the rope is frayed because that's the part they used to strangle Ibuki.
That sounds harsh.
I've been listening to you for a while, and it sounds like you knew about this rope clue all along. What exactly did you say to me during the investigation?
So, this rope won't be much of a clue. Then, I might as well search another place.
Not everyone cooperates at a class trial. Those who lie and conceal the truth will obviously be here too.
Exactly.
Just like this case's killer. I was just copying them a little bit.
Huh?
More importantly, what was all that about the rope? The killer strangled Ibuki. And then,
I finished speaking.
Oh, jeez, you're a jerk.
How is that a decisive clue?
Huh? You didn't notice it? I thought I made the decisive clue very clear.
Nagato's words contain a decisive clue? Is that really true? Make your argument. Who's for hanging?
Ibuki didn't die from hanging. She was strangled to death.
That's basically the same thing.
Though hanging and strangling seem similar, they're very different.
Yeah, there's...
The scars they leave would look different, too.
Scars? You mean the rope burn, right?
But we believed it was from a hanging. Why would that be?
Did we fall for someone's lie?
Yeah.
The body at the crime scene was hanged, you know. Obviously, we'd assume it was a hanging.
The Monokuma file complicates this, too. It never specified hanging or strangulation.
Whoever misunderstood is to blame!
What is it I need to shoot? Or, I know what I need to shoot. Lucas's true cause of death was strangulation. The fact is the decisive proof that will lead to the killer. Is it true?
Ibuki didn't die from hanging. She was strangled to death.
That's basically the same thing.
No hanging and strangling. The scars were made. Scars.
But we believe it was
only two truths.
Did we fall for someone's lie?
Two sims. Okay, that there we go. Be. Jeez, okay. I thought I'd already done this one. I'm stupid.
So that's what happened. We've been falling for the killer's lie this whole time.
Yeah. There's something I want to ask you. There's no doubt Ibuki's death was being hanged by this rope, right? Yes, she has no other external injuries, so there's no doubt she died from hanging herself. I see. So Ibuki died by hanging herself.
You said Ibuki hanged herself, but that was a complete lie, wasn't it, Mikan?
That is... Well...
You told us the wrong cause of death. You lied, didn't you?
Yep.
You should have been able to tell the difference between hanging and strangling. Just by looking.